So now that we've learned a bunch of new words related with classes and objects, we will move on to creating our movie website. And here is the final output that we're after: all of our favorite movies on a web page. And as you've seen previously, if we click on any one of these movies, we see its trailer. Let's build this. So here I am, back with my code. Now thus far, we've made only two movie objects: Toy Story and Avatar. I'm going to make a few more. In fact, four more movie objects. But before I do that, I want to make this window a little bit bigger so we can see all of this code really easily. Okay, so here are the two instances we've created thus far: Toy Story and Avatar. Now before I proceed, I will go ahead and comment out the previous output statements that I had created: this print statement and the show trailer method. So let me just add a comment there and there. Done. Now I'm going to add a new movie object for a movie called School of Rock. There it is. You will notice that I've changed the name of the movie, its storyline, its poster image, and its YouTube trailer values appropriately. Next, I will add another movie object, this time for an animated movie called Ratatouille. Next, I will add a movie object called Midnight in Paris. Now this happens to be one of my favorite movies. And the final movie object I will add is for a movie called The Hunger Games. Okay, so thus far, we've created six different movie objects. So far, so good. Now, to turn this into a movie website, you will need a piece of code that we wrote. Now, we call this code freshtomatoes.py. By the way, this file is available for you to download in the instructor notes. Now, before we use it, let's see what this file actually does. This file, freshtomatoes.py, has a function inside it called openMoviesPage. Let's look at this function a bit more closely. Now, what this function does is that it takes in a list of movies as input, and as output, it creates and opens an HTML page or a website that shows the movies you gave it in the first place. So what I'm going to do next is use this file, freshtomatoes.py, and its function openMoviesPage inside our code.